Last week, as others focused on gun policy, I suggested here a corresponding cause for our national tragedy. And today, in light of new information, let me say it flat out. The Florida school shooting was an epic intelligence failure. It should have been stopped. It never should have happened. In this technological world of Apple and Google, Facebook and Amazon, better management of data by law enforcement needs to keep us safe from mass killings, and better integration of that which was in a variety of databases should have kept us safe from this guy. I hate to say his name, but I need to in order to make my points. Nicholas Cruz was not living off the grid like the Unabomber Ted Kaczynski, far from it. He was totally plugged in to his community, to law enforcement, and to social media. There was a staggering amount of seemingly searchable information predicting his future path. Consider just some of the electronic breadcrumbs that he left behind. The Broward County Sheriff's Office received 23 calls about this one guy over 10 years, starting when Cruz was just 9 years old. That data was all recorded. Since 2010, law enforcement had to respond to his house 39 times, or in a classmate's words, almost every other week. And again, records were kept. The most serious warnings started in February of 2016 when an anonymous caller alerted police that the killer threatened on Instagram to shoot up the school. And Cruz posted pictures of himself with a gun, another electronic marker. 7 months later, a peer counselor reported that the killer possibly ingested gasoline, wanted to buy a gun, and attempted to commit suicide by cutting himself. Days later, an investigator for Florida's Department of Children and Families ruled him a low risk. Still, DCF had a thick file on this guy. That's more data which could have been integrated. And later that month, the family that initially took the killer in after his mother's death called police to report a fight.
911 emergency, how can I help you?
Yeah, there was a fight in my house. The kid and my son.
Okay,
I'm punching him, and now he left the house, but I need somebody here because I'm afraid he comes back and he has a lot of weapons.
What kind of weapon, ma'am?
Let me ask my son. What kind of weapon did he get that he's going to get?
A Remington.
Okay, and who did this?
Nicholas Cruz. It's not the first time he put a gun on somebody's head.
There's more. The family also revealing this disturbing detail.
He also dig in the backyard because he knew he was not allowed to bring it here, and we found that he did a size for the box. So he was going to bury the gun there.
The next day, a tipster from Massachusetts called the sheriff's office to report that Cruz was collecting guns and knives, telling them he will kill himself one day and believes he could be a school shooter in the making. On social media, Cruz posted comments like, I want to die fighting and I want to shoot people with my AR-15, yet more electronic footprints. And then there was his behavior at school. According to the Miami Herald, teachers and other students said that he kicked doors, that he cursed at teachers, that he fought with and threatened classmates, and brought a backpack with bullets to school. More markers. Student Samantha Fuentes, who was injured in the shooting, said students used to joke about Cruz being the next school shooter. Also, reports that an investigator with Florida's Department of Children and Families had previously warned the state of Cruz's intentions to buy a gun after his 18th birthday. And then, as predicted, in February of 2017, he purchased the AR-15 that he used to kill those 14 students and three faculty members. The transaction was perfectly legal, but you'd think that a background check should be able to detect all these prior warnings. Last September, a Mississippi bail bondsman flagged for the FBI a YouTube comment from a Nicholas Cruz saying, I'm going to be a professional school shooter. Now, the Washington Post reported that a Nexus search revealed only 22 so-named individuals. That's another searchable database. And still, they didn't stop him. And finally, the FBI admits that they failed to act on a January 5 phone call in which, according to the transcript, yet another unidentified caller told the FBI she feared Cruz was about to explode and was capable of, quote, getting into a school and just shooting the place up. I just want to get it off my chest in case something does happen, and I do believe something's going to happen. After receiving that call, an FBI employee discussed the tip with her supervisor and concluded there was no imminent threat. The case was closed within an hour. The information was never passed on to the FBI's Miami field office. And this is not even a full accounting that I'm giving you. It's inexcusable that all this data wasn't integrated. And I know some of you are listening, you're watching, and you're saying, well, there are civil liberties risks here. I get it. But the protection of Americans of all ages demands better data management about those who pose a gun risk. When any of us makes a rudimentary Amazon or Google search, we trigger all sorts of algorithms that make it hard for us to evade commercial suitors. Why shouldn't law enforcement have the same tools at their disposal? We were a keystroke away from catching this guy. Instead, 17 are dead. It is time to work smarter, not harder.